Welcome children to the new next session of the junk cellar. So today we'll be moving on with few more questions and few more concepts related to the chapter. Already we have discussed all kind of things which are required in this chapter, that is multiplication and the tables. So generally questions will be like that. You have been given the price of one thing and you have to carry out the price of many more items, such as the price of 1 kg apple is this much. You have to calculate what will be the price of 10 kg of apples. So these kinds of question may come. So now moving on, we have the few questions that we have to calculate. In that we have got it that first guess the answer and then calculate. So I do not know how to guess the answer, but more than if two digits we are multiplying, around 500 or more than 500 answer can be there. So you can use both the method, the box method and the multiplication method, to solve such questions. So we will be using both. Okay, so it depends on you that which method you use to calculate the answer. Okay, so we will be calculating 37 into 18. So now if we use the regular method, that is 37 into 18, we should be knowing the tables for using this method. So A7 is a 56, 5 will go up, 8 3 is a 24 plus 5 is 29. Now 1 7 is a 7, 1 3 is a 3. If we add all the both the numbers, 6, 9 plus 7 is 16, 1 will go here, then 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 3 is 6. So this is the answer. Now using box method, how will to do? Those who feel that box method is easy, we can divide 37 into 30 plus 7 and 18 into 10 plus 8. So here 300, 30 into 8 is 240, 10 into 7 70, and 7 8 is 56. So if we add all these numbers, 300 plus 240 plus 70 plus 56, we get the same answer, 660. So method can be different, but the answer is same. So it depends on our choice which method we are using to calculate the answer correctly. Okay, so next one is given. I suppose I'll solve the next one also for you. 45 into 24, we can use this also. Again we'll use both the methods. 45 into 24, 4 5 is a 20, 4 4 is a 16, 16 plus 2 18, 2 5 is a 10, 1 will go up, 2 4 is a 8 plus 1 9, we'll add 0, 8 plus 0 is 8, and here 10. So we got that answer, 1080. We'll use the box method to calculate. We can divide 45 into 40 plus 5 and 24 into 20 plus 4. So 20 into 40 will be 2 4 is a 8 and 2 0 here. 40 into 4 is 4 4 is a 16, last may 1 0. Then 4 5 is a 20 and 4 2 is a 10, last may 1 0. So if we add all these numbers, 800 plus 160 plus 100 plus 20, answer will be same. So either we can use this method, either we can use this method, we will get the both the same answer. Okay, so now moving on. So part D, E, F, G, H you have to do in your class. Okay, I will be posting in the WhatsApp group. Now moving on, Kiran is further telling what happened. Now Kiran, when she is collecting the garbage junk from the collector and selling at Dinu's big shop, she used to write all the details in a diary. Now some calculation we have to do based on our given information in the diary. Then Kiran bought some junk from the junk collectors. She paid them rupees 841. She sold the junk at Dinu's big shop and Dinu gave her these notes and coins. So in the picture we can see 100 rupees note, 20 rupee note, 5 rupee note and 1 rupee coin, and 10 rupee note and 50 rupee note. But if you will see, along with these notes the number is also mentioned, as both 6 notes of 100. It means there are 6 notes. Then 7 notes of 20, 8 notes of rupees 5, 4 coins of rupee 1, 3 notes of rupees 50, and 6 notes of rupees 10. So Dinu gave her these coins. Now she had to calculate that how she got the money. So for calculation, what we'll do? Again, we'll do the board. So 6 notes of 100, it means 6 into 100, that is 600. Then 7 note of 20, 7 into 20, 140. Then what is given? 8 note of rupees 5. So 8 into 5, 8 5 is a 40. Then 4 coins of rupee 1, it means 4. Further, we have 3 notes of 50 and 6 notes of 10. So 3 into 50, it means rupees 150. And how many notes of 10 rupees? 6 notes. So we'll write 6 into 10, that is 60. So if now we'll add all these numbers, we'll get 4, 4 plus 4, 8, 8 plus 5, 13, 13 plus 6, 13, and 19. 1 will go. So 7, 1 plus 6 is 7, 8 and 9. So now she got rupees 994. Who? Dinu. Dinu gave 992 to Kiran. Okay, so now come back again. What is happening here? Now see below, you can see the page from the Kiran's diary, that when she gave the amount to the junk collector, she gave the amount of rupees 841. It means jo usne junk kharida tha collector se, wo kitne mein kharida? Rupees 841. But Dinu gave the amount of rupees how much? He gave the amount of rupees 94. It means she is getting more money from Dinu. So let's see how much of profit, how much of profit or benefit she got. So for this, we'll do that. We will minus rupees 990. So because this is the money that Dinu gave, and this is the money Kiran gave to the junk collector. So we'll minus 4 minus 1 is 3, 9 minus 4 is 5, and 9 minus 8 is 1. So it means Kiran ne kya kiya? Kiran buy the junk for rupees 841, but she sold for 994. It means she got a profit of rupees 153. Again, we have to come to the concept that if selling price is more than cost price or buying price, then there is profit. Okay, if selling price is more than cost price or buying price, then there is profit. In simple language, apple rupees 5, Mohan is having apple of rupees 5. Now he sell to Sohan for 10 rupees. So now he is selling the apple to Sohan for 10 rupees. It means he is selling for more price. It means Mohan has profit. Kitne rupees ka profit hua? Rupees 10 minus rupees 5. It means rupees 5 ka profit hua. So now moving on. So in this you can see the page from the Kiran's diary where she has maintain a record that money she got 600, 150, 140, 60, 40 and 4. and after adding all this she got 994 rupees. And when she minus the amount which she gave to the garbage collector, she got the difference. It means money she earned is rupees 150. So she is getting a good amount of profit. Now moving on. Now later she paid 919 to junk collector. So next time when junk collector came to Kiran shop to sell the items, she gave 919. And when she sold the junk, she got these notes again. So again a next day or after 1 week whatsoever, she got all the junk to the Dinu shop. And Dinu gave these amount of money to Kiran. So now we have to calculate again that how much money Dinu gave to Kiran. 28 coins of rupees 5. If you see properly, this is 5 rupees coin. 5 notes of rupees 100, 1 note of rupees 50, 18 notes of rupees 10, and 9 notes of rupees 20. So how do we calculate? Again, we'll multiply and add. It means 28 into 5, 5 is 40, 4 upar gaya, 5 2 is 10, 1 40. So 5 notes of how much? 100. So 5 into 100 is 500. Then 1 note of 50, it means 50 only. Then we have 18 notes of 10 and 9 notes of 20. 18 into 10, it means 180, and 9 note of 20, 2 nines are 18. So this is the money Dinu gave to Kiran. So if we will add all this, we will get 0 plus 0 plus 0. Now 4 plus 5 is 9. 9 plus 8 is 17. 17 plus 8 is 25. Then 2 will go up. 2 plus 1 is 3. 3 plus 5 is 8, 9 and 10. So she got the amount rupees 1050. So Dinu gave rupees 1052 Kiran. But how much the amount Kiran is gave to the junk collector? She gave 919. So again now she has to make a record in the diary. If you are having a textbook, you can use the pencil and make all the entries here. Otherwise, I'll tell you how to do. No, so now she got rupees 1050. So it means how much profit she got. So we'll divide and we'll get the profit. So we'll minus rupees 1050 rupees 919. So it is 0 here, so we'll bring 1 from here. 10 minus 9 is 1, so here it was now become 4, because 1 udhar carry kar liya humne. 4 minus 1 is 3, so here it was 10 only, because it was 0 here, so we will carry. So out of 10 minus 9 is rupees. So this was the profit made to Kiran. So now she got, so every time when what she is doing, when she is selling the junk to Dinu shop, it means she is buying the junk from junk collectors at a normal or low price, but she is selling at a more price. That's how she is getting large amount of profit, so that she can earn and she can earn a livelihood. So that's all for today. So I will be posting the class of today in the WhatsApp group. And with this, we have come to the end of the chapter. So for this, learn tables from 2 to 20 for fast calculations. And don't use the calculator. Thank you. Have a nice day.